The Philippine Navy is beefing up its littoral defense with the commissioning of two brand new units of fast attack interdiction craft. Bianca Dava joins us for details. Bianca?
Hi, Denise. The Philippine Navy is, yes, beefing up its littoral defense with the christening of two brand new units of fast attack interdiction craft. Littoral defense refers to operations in and around the littoral zone within a certain distance of shore. Armed Forces of the Philippines, or AFP Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Bartolome Bacaro, led the christening of the two FAIC at the Philippine Navy headquarters in Manila this morning. The ships are the first two of nine acquired from Israel with a budget of 10 billion pesos, inclusive of missile and weapon systems. The first two vessels were named after Philippine Marine Corps heroes and Medal of Valor recipients. The late Private First Class Nestor Acero and the late First Lieutenant Lorinato Toong. The two FAICs were formally launched on June 26 and successfully passed the sea trials in Israel from June 27 to 30. Three more units are slated to be delivered beginning next year, while the remaining four will be constructed at the Philippine Navy Shipyard in Naval Station Pascual Ledesma, Cavite City. The acquisition of the new FAICs is the latest effort of the Philippine Navy in its pursuit to become a modern and multi-capable naval force. It is also among the 2019 projects approved by former President Rodrigo Duterte under the Horizon 2 list of the revised AFP Modernization Program. To further help sailors upgrade their capability and assert more efficiency in the conduct of their mandate, Philippine Navy Vice Admiral Adeluis Bordado said they are set to participate in several naval exercises in Indonesia, Brunei, Australia, and the U.S. this year. Denise?
Thanks, Bianca. Philippine inflation eases slightly in August. The consumer price index eased to 6.3% from 6.4% in July. That's due to the slower increase in the cost of transportation and select food and beverages. The latest inflation print falls within the central bank's forecast of 5.9 to 6.7%. But it's above the government's target of 2 to 4% for the fifth straight month. The BSP says upside risks continue to dominate its inflation outlook in the near term due to higher global non-oil prices, the continued shortage in domestic fish supply, the sharp increase in the price of sugar, as well as pending petitions for transport fare increases. The BSP adds it is prepared to take further policy actions to help bring inflation toward a target consistent path over the medium term. The central bank's benchmark interest rate is currently at 3.75%. For its part, the National Economic and Development Authority vows to continue implementing subsidy programs that would reduce transport and logistics costs. It also stresses the importance of agricultural reforms to speed up economic recovery and to significantly reduce poverty in the country. As for the finance department, it vows to provide support to sectors affected by elevated inflation. These include fuel subsidies for the transport sector, fuel discounts for farmers and fisherfolk, and social pension for indigent senior citizens. Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno adds, government will also work to improve local production and ensure adequate food supply.